There are many benefits associated with resveratrol, such as antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, anti-proliferative, anti-angiogenic effects. If you are considering taking resveratrol, make sure you are taking pure trans-Resveratrol, which is the active form. Hi, I'm Lily with VitaHelix. Today, I'll show you the differences between pure trans-Resveratrol and natural resveratrol by using an important analytical technique called high-performance liquid chromatography, HPLC. Before I start, if you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe to be updated on dietary supplements backed by science. If you like this video and wish more people can see it, give us a thumbs up. It's really gonna help us to increase our visibility. So, let's get started. To test the purity, we will be using high-performance liquid chromatography, also known as HPLC. To make it simple, HPLC is an analytical technique used to separate, identify, and quantify each component in a mixture of organic compounds with high precision and accuracy. Here, we have two samples from two different companies that I purchased on Amazon. Since it is not our goal to make judgment to any company, but to help you discern what the reliable products are in the market, I will call them sample A and sample B. Sample A was dissolved in methanol, filtered, and placed into HPLC instrument to measure its purity. In this type of analysis, the instrument will generate a chromatogram, which is just a fancy name to describe a graph with multiple peaks that can be interpreted as fingerprint of each molecule existing in your sample. The same procedure will be conducted for sample B. As you can see, sample A is a white powder, and sample B is a brown powder. When dissolved in methanol, sample A became a transparent solution, whereas sample B turned to a reddish brown solution. After being auto-injected in the HPLC instrument, it normally takes about 20 to 30 minutes to collect all the data based on the developed HPLC method. Now, let's take a look at the result. In sample A, we can see in the chromatogram, y-axis represents the intensity of absorbance in milliabsorbance units, whereas the x-axis is the units of time, typically minutes, and is used to determine the retention time of each peak. I'm just being oversimplistic here. The retention time is like an ID number of each organic molecule. By using the same method under the same conditions, the sample show retain the same retention time. Sample A here showed an intense and sharp peak with retention time at 12.1 minutes, indicating a very pure sample with a purity almost 99%. The retention time at 12.1 minutes matches with standard pure trans-resveratrol, further confirming the identity. As for sample B, the chromatogram also showed an intense sharp peak at 12.1 minutes. However, multiple peaks were observed with considerable intensity, making the purity of sample B only 61%. Like I mentioned before, each peak represents individual impurity. Therefore, there are many impurities found in sample B. Comparing the two analyses, we can see a huge difference between these two resveratrol products. In my case, I have access to lab instrument, which makes it easy for me to test my supplement's purity and chemical content. But what about you? What can you do to differentiate between a good and bad resveratrol product if you don't have access to a chemistry lab? Here is what you should be doing when buying resveratrol. First, aim for trans-Resveratrol with purity 98% or higher. Pure trans-Resveratrol is an off-white powder, while the impure one has a brown color. Second, check the company's reputation, transparency, and whether the product is manufactured in a GMP-compliant facility. Third, find out if the company can provide the certificate of analysis, also called COA, to ensure the quality of your product. Don't forget to check out our website. I'll leave a link below. I hope you like this video. Stay tuned for more videos about quality assurance behind the dietary supplements. As always, stay healthy and live longer.